Yeah,
Okay.
then we switch.
Okay, you are live with the camera and screen.
Okay, then thanks. Yeah, then so screen is also live.
Yes, everything.
Okay, great. So yeah, then welcome to my session, Power Apps, mixed reality. So I would say it's rather the fun part. Yeah, I will show you some controls that may not many people used already, what you can do with 3D models and Power Apps. Power Apps is one of the first platforms and low-code, no-code platforms where you can build this kind of AR mixed reality apps. Yeah, and I don't have any slides for you. I thought it's a developer bootcamp, and yeah, we just struggle a little bit together through Power Apps and build a small app where I explain and demo the capabilities. If you want, you don't need any prepared models or something like this. You can follow all that stuff. You're free to join me and do it in parallel while the session. Yeah, then I would say let's get started. Okay, so we have a few scenarios that I want to show to you. And let's start. What is the first scenario that we can do? The first scenario that we are going to build is, let's give it a name, is we want to view 3D models. There are actually two things behind it, what you can do. You can just view 3D models within the app. And you can show them in mixed reality in AR on your environment. So I will cover both these cases in this one demo. That is one thing that you can do here with Power App. Another scenario that we can do is we can place a volume. The idea behind the story is you define a volume, the length, the height, the depth on something, and then you can place this volume somewhere in your environment so that you see if it may fit where you want to put it. That's another case you can do with Power Apps mixed reality. And then we have a third case that you can do. It's you can measure things in your environment and see later on the measures. So let's start with the first part, view 3D model. So let's create a new blank screen for this. Let's give it a label. D model viewer. And I think we also should put in a back button that we can go back to the main screen. Oh no, that's the wrong icon. That's looking for a back icon. Yeah, that will do the job. So first some basic stuff. So as I say, feel free to join it. So I navigate back to the home screen. Let's uncover a nice effect. Let's build first the navigation. And here, I may choose a better name. We have later on more screens. Okay, let's see that everything works so far. Okay. So now the first thing we need is we need some models that we can choose, kind of a catalog. So we will put in a gallery. Let's choose a blank vertical gallery. So there are some options where you can load the models from. You can give it a direct URL. With the GLB file, that's something we also should talk a little bit about it, because talking too much about it, that's a science of itself, 3D formats. Currently, Power Apps only supports GLB files or GTLF. It's pretty much the same. One is a compressed package. The other one is the open format. It's an open source file format that's recently get a lot of extension. Before it was FBX, but there are really plenty and tons of 3D formats, also a difference between TRISC-based formats like the ones I mentioned, then there are the CAD formats like STEP and something like this. It's really a science of itself, all the formats. In our case, we will not go too deep in this. When you have some questions about how you can convert things, just write me on Twitter or shoot me an email. I have plenty of experience how to convert things. You can use sometimes tools like Blender, or there are some open source tools, some console tools like ASM. I also have some demos how you can host that in an Azure function or in a Docker container. So we don't want to go too deep in the 3D model formats. So you can load it from a direct URL, or you can also load it from SharePoint, or you can give it back as base 64 from a flow. In our case, we choose SharePoint. I think that's the most obvious part in our Microsoft 365 platform. So let's create a new site for our models. Okay, just the team side should be ready in a second. Okay, so what we need is a list. The easiest way to load, I call the list models. The easiest way to do it is with a list. It would be nicer to do it with a document library, because SharePoint has also some great other tools to visualize it. I'm not sure if everybody is aware, but SharePoint can visualize in 3D a lot of different formats. SharePoint get really good in managing, storing 3D formats. But in Power App, we can only use the attachment directly. If we want to store the models in a document library, we would need a flow that transforms the document into Base64 and then return it in this format. That would be another way to do it, but we want to keep the things here simple. So we just take the most easiest way. So, but now we need some models. So where do you get 3D models to play with? In your company, you may have 3D models, or depending on the business you are in. There are some platforms where you can buy some nice demos for rather demo models, because they're rather for real time and gaming. This platform like a TurboSquid, they have a lot of models, but not very perfect for smaller models that work on the phone. There are some platforms where you can build them, but we want to keep things simple. There is a tool on your computer, it's called 3D Viewer. You can also use your computer to put things into mixed reality. And there is a library. There is a 3D library where we can just steal some models to play with. So let me see which category we choose. What we have here. I think Birdie, we had this morning already with Jamie the Halloween theme, so I think that would be scary for your Halloween experience in AR. So we choose this one. And then you can export that model. Oh, no, not export, sorry, it's save as. And you see it's the format GLTF binary. Just put it on the desktop. And let's choose one other model. Let me see, science fantasy. I don't know. The angry eye. The angry eye that looks angry. So now we have two models. Now we add them here. One was birdie. Yeah, it takes a second, so birdie is in. And the angry eye. Jamie, how much would it give on your angry, on your scary score?
Hard to say, man. It looks pretty harsh to me.
Okay, yeah, I see. I think I also get soon angry eyes when I see the message here, no, I'm not responding. Yeah. I see. I see. I have to restart the browser, I guess. Oh, I see. Why the hell was this Microsoft Edge?
If you can't have demo gremlins at Halloween, when can you have them?
Yeah. I see, I see. So let's close the session. Oh, yeah, now the whole Explorer. It was too scary for me. It was too scary for my computer. Too scary. It seems my whole Explorer crashed.
The demo effect,
Christian. Huh? I really seem to have no good luck with demos, even a Power App demo. Uploading a file in SharePoint seems to be too hard. I don't know.
Yes.
Yeah, the Task Explorer also.
But in the meantime, you can write a PowerShell script to upload a file.
Yeah, I rather need something that brings back my my Explorer, because if not, I have to do a restart, which would be quite unfortunately in the session, right? So anybody a smart trick what you do then when you can do nothing? Yeah, I don't have it. No, guys, so I really think I have to do a restart. So maybe somebody.
Yeah, we can make some jokes in the meantime.
Exactly.
Don't worry. So we have a lot of Italian, German, and Swiss jokes at disposal.
Yeah.
So you can restart and. We will continue.
Oh, my Task Explorer is like, maybe 1 second, maybe now. Oh yeah, it comes back.
Okay.
Okay. Heard that we are doing some jokes, so it's better.
Yeah, it's when you said Swiss jokes. It came back straight
yeah,
away.
Yeah, I got it.
So okay, it's somehow yeah. Okay, now we have our two models in. Finally, that should be the easy part, uploading a file in SharePoint. Okay, so we have here our gallery, so we need a data source, we need SharePoint. And where is our library? Let's connect it. Let's connect our model library. So I think we want to only show or just add this as a data source. And then put in a label to show. Yeah, okay, the name is already right there. Let's make it a little cleaner. I think that's also could be a little nicer. Yeah. In the meantime, Emanuele could totally tell the people how much he liked Power Apps. He's a really huge fan.
It's very easy to tell.
So, okay. And yeah, then we need also another control. So now we have our two models here. And here are some controls, but in this, I don't know why they put media when you just want to show the model without putting it into AR mixed reality, you will find it under media view in 3D preview. So, and it's still all that stuff is preview. Okay, and in this you get automatically a demo object loaded here that you can use. So now we have to load our model when we select here something. So let's make that also a little nicer here. Put an icon inside that we see what we selected. Want to build an awesome Power App, I think I search here. Oops. Rectangle. Boom. Yeah, great. So just make a indicator here, which model we have loaded. Okay. Make it a little smaller. Okay, now we have an indicator. Now we have to do something with it when we select the model. Yeah, not perfect. So, and we choose, action on select, and then we save the model in the context. You can do that in Power App with update context. I think it's pretty similar when you use something like React, where you work with bindings, and internally I think Power App does it in this way. So now we can in a JSON, with kind of JSON define variables that we have in our context here. Let's choose the current item, and this is this item, and we choose something else. We want to the file, the model. That's a little more special. We need the first attachment. So you can have more than one attachment. In our demo, we only take the first attachment. And then we have the first attachment as model. So as soon as somebody click it, we remember the item. We just do this to compare which one is selected. To make it here nice, so we say, if visible, our indicator should be only be visible when item ID, I think I call this, it doesn't matter, this item ID, when they are, then we know it's selected, then it should be visible. If not, it should not be visible. Okay. You were expecting a Boolean value. Oh yeah, what have I done there? That makes more sense for sure. Okay. Let's see what happened when we select one. Okay, we select one and we see now we have our selection mode. Now we want to load that here. So we bind this. And there is a source sample 3D object, and we want to bind this with our, I call it model, and then a model has a value, and this is actually our 3D model. So I save, because seems today I don't have the best luck. Okay. And yeah, let's start the app. And now we see I can choose the models. Yeah, it takes always a few seconds. Then you have some typical functions that you can move around the things, or you can just build an easy 3D viewer. I think there are scenarios when you have products and you want to show them. Maybe it's interesting for larger products when you have a watch or something. You can bring those products to your customer, but I don't know. You sell some machines and you could show the machines in 3D on your Power app, on your tablet, or things like that. You can build an easy visualizer for your 3D models. And yeah, so load the other one, our birdie. Our scary Halloween model. Yeah. Okay. So that's the first thing you can build with it. You can build a model. You can view 3D models. What else have we? Now, even the interesting part is now we want to see this model in mixed reality. In AR. So now we choose another control from our preview, and then we have view in MR. Let's put this here. Yeah, we can here also use a little more space for our model. So we can see, you can specify the unit of measurement. By default, it will use the measurement from the object. You will find objects from the 3D model. They are super large, then the model is super huge when you put it in your room. You can limit that, for example, that you say, okay, your model should be limited to 20 centimeters so that it will be not too large. So you can set here the measurements. So, and then for sure it needs a source, and this is again our model. It should be value. Sorry, it should be value. Okay, now you want to try it. And you click on this and you get the message mixed reality supported device required. You need to test it on the device. That's maybe the most annoying part when you work with this, because you always have to deploy it to your device to check it. Actually, it uses the AR kit and the AR core from I'm not sure since when it's supported in the Apple devices and Google. You need a rather current phone. And then it uses the functionality from ARKit and AR Core to do this. So let's save it and publish it. And we want to watch it on our device. Publish this. So now wish me luck when I try to do my screen sharing. Oh, that looks good. That looks good. So now you see my phone and our M365 Power app. Yes, we want to allow the access to camera and SharePoint. Let's go to view 3D model. Let's choose our scary birdie. Yeah, and here we go. You can also play here with the model. But even the more interesting part is click on view in MR. So now it scans with the AR kit. It scans the environment, and now we can place it somewhere. Oh, I still have it a little large, I see. I didn't scale it down, so I get up, and so yeah, I still have it a little large in my room. So that's when you don't scale it. It may will be a little large for my room here, and it's pretty stable. So it really stands here. Yeah, this is our scary birdie. Let's give the other model a try. Hope this is not that large. Yeah, so let's put our angry eye. I hope it has no real tank size, then it would be, yeah, not very much place here. So let's put it here. Okay, this is okay. So you also can turn the models. Yeah, and you can put it in your room. I think that's really pretty easy. You can't do much more with this. You just can place them there. You can imagine you want, yeah, you want to show, let's say, a car or something really large. You can put it really into the environment, show it to your customer. Or it's even fun when you want to just show it to your colleagues or to show it to your kids. Put a unicorn inside, and so you're at home also with this Power App Demo, the king. So there are plenty of things you can do it with it. In practice, I don't see that people doing too much with it, but I think there are some neat scenarios where the customers rather impressed when you can show your demos in such a way, or your models or your products. Okay, that's you in MR, but you can do a little more. We can also do pictures. To do so, we will find there is, in the view MR, there is an onChange method. And we want to collect the pictures that we do. You can do mixed reality captures. We use the collect function for this. And just call it all pics. Does not really matter. And then I didn't give them great name. I think it's called, how is that thing called? UNMR. Here we go. And then it has the photos. So now every time we do a mixed reality capture, it does a photo. So we have to do something with the photo. Let's put a button there. I didn't want to put it inside here. Just add a button. Your pics. Add another screen. Just take a blank again before I struggle too much with the name. Screen pics. So, and we need now, I put a gallery. I just take flexible height. I just show it like this. Okay, we choose this example. So we don't need the text. Second, we don't need the subtitle. That was one too much. So the image, for sure, we want to see the image. See how big, how large we get it. So now we have a small gallery here. Now we have our all pics. One second. Here must go our all pics. And then here it should be this item image URL. So there's nothing in. Oh yeah, this should maybe bring in a back button so that we can leave our screen again. Let's put it back. Navigate. Screen. Let's go back then. And for sure, we need to navigate to the screen. Let's go. Unselect, sorry. I hit the wrong box. Navigate. Screen picks. So there's no chance to test it here. So when you do a mistake, it's always a little annoying because you have to republish it again. Let me do my screen mirror again. So let's publish. The mirroring is up again. Let's close our app. It now should, yeah, let's say there is a new version. That's correct. View 3D model. Let's take the angry eye here. We do it in MR. Now just yeah, place it here. And now we want to have a, yeah, we turn it a little bit. We want to see it from the front. And now let's do some nice shots of it. Go back. And when we now didn't do a mistake and I click on view pics, now we see we have our mixed reality picture. So I think it's a case like if you have products like IKEA, people can place your products. Okay, it's not for end consumer power apps, but you can place things in your office. Have a look how it would look like, how it would fit in there. So pretty much cases that people do with the IKEA app. So okay, now you want, that's all, that's a little tricky, that's why I show it. Now you may want to do something with it because you don't want only have the picture on your device. You may want to store it in OneDrive and you want to do something with it. So we put an action here where we upload it to OneDrive. Want to do something with it. Yeah, because Jamie gave us a nice introduction about Power Automate Flow. And for sure, we want to now leverage our knowledge that that we got from Jamie this morning. So what we want to do is we want to use Power Automate. And we want to create a new flow. We choose Power App button. Oh, I'm not signed in. No, not this one. I want to use my demo account. So now we are here. There it is. So publish picture. Okay, now we have here the chance to receive data from Power App. How does this work? Let's say we want to save it. First step, we want to save it in our OneDrive. OneDrive, come on. OneDrive for business. We want to create a file. Let's put it in the root. My model, JPEG. And yeah, now it's a little bit the tricky part. First, you can say ask in Power Apps you needed a binary, but then you have also to do some other things to transfer it in the right format. So now we have here create a file content. Now we need a expression. Yeah, we have to. You get this in the format in a data URI. So we need it then to decode that into a into the binary one. So that's always a little tricky when you work with files and things like that with Power App and Flow. So we need to decode the data URI. But there is a little more you have to do because it will be surrounded with. I show you. So it will be. We have to replace it. So we have to replace this character with nothing. If not, it will not work. It's really annoying to troubleshoot it, but you have to do that. So you can watch it in recording when you may have problems with it. So we have to replace this. And now here at the first part should go our model. So I don't like to write the trigger body selection myself. So I usually put the cursor inside here and then choose this. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, so, but now we have more chance to watch that again, what I did. So watching it twice is better for learning. So we replace again. We have to replace. Sorry, it's too long. You choose this. We replace this. Yeah, again, for nothing. Now I don't want to lose it again. Okay, I don't know why it didn't work in the first place. So I like to use it like this, so you don't do a typing mistake. It's actually, it's always the, it starts with a file name and makes an underscore under it. Okay, that should do the trick. But let's make it a little more funny so that people see what awesome things we built here. So let's tweet it also, our awesome picture. We have now all the logic we need anyway. So tweet of the text. What's our hashtag actually? So that's also a good thing. I see who really built that stuff. So when you build it or just follow this, just post a tweet, put the hashtag in it. Power Apps Mixed Reality Demo. And yeah, that's the text. Okay, the media, we want to post some media. We just can take exactly that thing that we, what we use here already. Now, it's an expression box. Okay, let's give it a try. So when we click on publish, oh yep, and our flow is here. Yeah, would be maybe too easy when you just would do it like this item image. Oh, lost the cursor. So image URI. Here we go. So that would be too easy. That will not work. There is a new function. It will just send this internal URL to the internal storage of Power Apps. So this will not work. There's a new function. It's called JSON. You convert it to a data URI, and you can then say here, include binary data. So this should do the trick. Now cross your fingers. We will publish. Let's bring the air server up again. Okay, let's refresh the app. Oh no, that's the wrong one, sorry. As a new version. And now we choose view in 3D again. And let's choose the angry eye. View and mixed reality. Yeah, just go ahead and put it here. And yeah, let's do some nice shot of it. So view picks. Yeah, so I like the first one. So let's try to publish it. So now it's getting, it seems finally here. I have a better luck. And it seems like, let me see, let me verify it. What's still on screen? So.
Yes, I see your tweet, Christian.
What? You can
I see your tweet on Twitter.
Lucky you.
Nice.
Yeah, let me see. Yeah, it should be there. Yeah, exactly. It's like it is. So so everybody who built this demo have to send this post. Yeah, that's what you can do. So Stefan Bauer already read it and liked it. Okay, the other scenarios are rather quick. That was the more complicated one because officially I think we run soon out of time, but it's an online meeting, you can anyway quit every time. But I hope not. Okay, we go back. The other scenarios are rather easy. Let's do a new screen for the measuring. So we even don't need it. It's pretty easy. So let's exchange this against the control. So now we have the other control that will be quite easy. Shape, what did I click there? Mixed reality. And then we have view shape in MR. It's called shape, but it currently only supports the cube because I think it's preview. But cube is the most important one. You see here, you can specify the unit of measurement, and then you can define the shape, the width, the height, the depth. So for sure, it makes sense to have now some controls where you can set it, and then you can configure a cube, and then you can put it into the environment. Just make a small cube here. Just do the height 20. Okay, and that's it pretty much. You just can configure this, and now let's see what we got. Again, bring up the live server. Did I click actually on publish? Yeah. So screen is back to the server. So that's, as I said, that's not perfect. You have to always switch your device, but it's fine. So here's our power app again. Let's see what we got. Quit it. Just refresh it. A new version. So place a cube. Where do we put that cube? Let's put it here. So it's a rather small cube. I could check the volume if it would fit nice into the flat. You know, maybe that it will fit exactly in this area. So you can configure it. I choose now 20 to 10 centimeters, so it's not that large. That's what you can do with it. You can try to measure things and see if something fits there, a machine in your factory, for example. So, and then we have one more scenario. Then we have the measure. We also just take the measure here. So let's exchange the button here. Measure in mixed reality, also preview. Let's maybe put it also immediately directly below. You get the measures out of it. The idea is you can measure things. Just put here for a quick demo the output from the measurement here. So we bind it to, yeah, well, it's a little late in time. So you get, there's a property where you get just a little list of the measurements, not very complicated. You also have to set what you want, what if you want meters or what you want in the measurement. Then you have a measurement typed. That depends a little bit what you get. You get just out of it all the lines, all the measurements of all the lines you did. But when you can also measure more than one thing, you can measure volumes and cubes, and then you get the whole distances and the volume of the cube, all that things you get out of the measure control. Oh, but let's see how it works in mixed reality, what you get out here. So let's publish again. Bring up the screen mirroring. Yeah, now it doesn't find the. Oh, yeah, now it's back. So surface book. So Power Apps. Refresh. Take this new version, measure in MR. Now let's say take the measurement of my keyboard here. Just set a point here, and then a point here. Then we set a point here. And then set a point here. Yeah, that was not perfect. And now we connect them. So you see it can connect it. So it looks like it's 45 centimeters. So you can also measure volumes. You can also go up, and later on you can get out of this control all your measurements. See, I could also put now a line to somewhere else, and yeah, it checks also that the lines are connected. So that's pretty much what you can do with mixed reality in Power Apps. As I said, it's currently in preview, but I think you can build some neat demos pretty easy. Maybe AR looks like rocket science, but Power Apps make it extremely easy. So now there would be the chance for the questions. Do we have something? No, nobody have questions about mixed reality. Yeah, I think all are busy building that scary Halloween mixed reality demos. So David, would give back to you and say thank you to everybody who watched this. Glad that you joined it. And I hope we could inspire you here a little bit.
Yes, thank you, Christian. Thank you also to the older speakers. It was pretty amazing the content that we saw today. I hope you also enjoyed it. Last call to action is to fill out the survey. I will share the link once again in the chat window. Feel free to reach out of us if you have any questions, and otherwise feel free to also check if you want to attend another Microsoft 365 developer bootcamp in another location. And with this, I would like to close the session. Almost noon, so ready for you get lunch. I would like to thank you again for joining, and I wish you a nice Friday and a nice weekend. Stay safe, stay healthy. Bye-bye. Yes.
Thank you, David. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Yeah. Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.